Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing something special for me because I normally do my flip-throughs but for journals. But today I'm going to try to make a kind of craft with me. Sorry. And it's also a design team project for After Midnight Design because I will use parts of her junk journal kit irises. I made already some journals with this beautiful kit, and now I will use parts of them for a collage spread. So I'm using this journal I made. It's a real junk journal, I would say. On the outside, like a big tome with fabric. One day I will put something on top, don't know yet. And in the inside there are just random papers, lots of magazine papers, most of the times from Daphne's diary. And there are also just random papers, leftovers. And yeah, I want to work on this journal, and I decided to make something with this. So it's actually here. This is end of a signature. There are 20 signatures, so quite big one, and the first page of a signature. Nevertheless, I want to find a way to combine them at some point to make it like a spread. So obviously I need to cover this. I love this as a background for something, and I want to cover this. So, I prepared some papers, but I don't know exactly what I want to do. Maybe I will start with the background of some point. I printed out some papers with shades of dusty rose, I would say. I first aim was it to find the color tone of this, and there are three different color tones, pastel colors, and I decided to use them all. There's just a little collage here. I hope this will work out. Yeah, I will start in this corner, I think, and we'll stagger them a bit and we'll spread out here. I think I will rip. Don't want it too straight, but also not too ripped. So I will fold this at first and then just like so, a little bit. This is obviously too long. This way. I just figured it doesn't matter how this looks like because I will stagger. So that's okay. So I take my glue and my glue book. I don't ink these pieces up because I want this to blend in with the background. Now I take this color. So I will leave this a little bit longer. So I need another piece, and this is the lightest version. For me it's quite challenging because the unusual background is not so vintage, but maybe I can get it a bit more vintage. We will see. Let me see how long I will. Yeah, I like that. That's cute. Yeah, it looks not so bad. And yeah, I decided after I was thinking a lot what I'm gonna do today, but best thing is when you work like you always do, like I always do, very intuition. So sorry, sometimes often my English is so bad. Shall I put something here? Or so. Yeah, somehow I don't like this image here, so I will do another strip. I will tear off another strip. Let me see if this works. Yes, I have an idea. I want to see these flowers. It's funny, but I like that. It's a bit unexpected. So let's do this. Yeah, that's cool for my taste, at least. So now I can think about putting some irises, right? Let me see. Make something pink. Yeah, these ones. And I want it to spread out to the other side a bit. So, and I will rip, or shall I fuzzy cut? Oh, at first I will try to rip. You just hold your thumb nearby. Okay, this is too much here. So somehow I feel that I want to fuzzy cut this side to see more of the background. So now I will cut this also out. So I think I need something there. But not much. Yeah. I guess that's cute. So not much and just a little thing there. Yeah, let's do this or this way. No, that way. So I will, now we have this here. Somehow. Okay, first of all I have to do something here. And I will continue with these rosy stripes. So let me grab maybe the darker one. Oh, where's the dark one? Here's the dark one. Yeah. Maybe this way, so I can see this pink petal, which is cute. Yeah, let's do this. Yeah, and I will further cut this out. For sure. I wasn't sure, but now I am sure. Good thing, right? Now I guess I have to edit this. This will be very, very long. I thought just a little project, but yeah, it's not so easy. So my camera paused or stopped recording, and I just glued down this thing here. And now let's go on. Okay, so this is the centerpiece, the focus, and I really like it, I have to say. Yeah. Now, before I think about what to do here, I will think about this. I would like to make some kind of side pocket situation with flip outs, a long strip of coffee dyed lightweight cardstock. Let me do this at first, and let me organize this a little bit. So where is, yeah, this is also from the kit. There are long pockets, but I will use, I guess, this one as a flip out, so I can leave this flap on, but I will cut off the other two flaps. And I will fold the flap. You can also score, but I just fold it and like so. Not exactly on the fold, a little bit, so that you can move it. Yeah, that's nice. Shall be writing space. I will also ink a little bit, like my greeneries. This will be in the end. And where are my little pieces? My little iris pieces. Some other papers. Yes, I think I like a little bit darker background, like such and so forth. Something with color. She there. Just like so. So first I will ink. So that's where we are right now. I did some little things off camera. I sewed around the side pocket here and glued it on the page, made some more decoration, like this die cut here and this little tab, also from the iris kit, and here a little snippet piece here on the back. And I also put another die cut here to the irises. So now I think I will prepare a nice journal card for the side pocket to finish all this up. And I did a little preparation, so I have this journal card. It's originally was a pocket where I just cut off the tabs. So it's also from an iris kit. You can use this also as journal card. Put sewed some lace and sari silk on the side, and thought I would just make a little collage here with the snippet from one journal page left over and this die cut. So let's do this. And when we, I will wait a little bit till it's dry. And now I have this little piece of fabric, and I just sewed some lace on it. This will be a tab here. Because I want something to balance the colors a bit. Here it's more yellow, here it's more a cold color scheme, and I wanted to bring some more yellowish or vintage looking element here on this side. We'll glue this on with fabric tag. On camera, I'm a bit confused. So, still gluey hands. I found my cap from the glue finally. So, and I will make a little cluster here with one of the mini ephemera pieces from the iris kit. Maybe like so, a bit staggered, and this ticket is also from the iris kit. Something like that, and then this die cut, like so. For demonstration purposes, dries very fast, and I'm gluing on fabric, so might be a good idea to use fabric tack. I think this is a nice position. I want to see the stitching. And first I wanted to stagger it, but then there wouldn't be a tuck spot anymore, so we do it like this. Almost finished. I like this a lot. Let me put the journal card here, and now you see there's not only that you have another journal card for writing as such, this is also another decoration for the whole spread. Very cute, I think. And now I want to stamp a word. And this word will be my favorite word, faith, at the moment. And let me see where I put it. And I think I will use this vertical strip here. Just take my little letter stamps. I should organize them before. Now we're going to stamp. Mustn't be perfect. So, now I'm done. This is my iris layout, iris collage page and design team project for After Midnight Design for March. So guys, thank you very much for watching this video, and I say bye till next time. Tschüss, bis zum nächsten Mal.